Another common rule to use is Chebychev's rule. Chebychev's rule is very much like the empirical rule, but the big difference is Chebychev applies to any shape of data. And as you recall, the empirical rule specifically needed mound shape data. If I looked at my data and it looked reasonably mound shaped, empirical rule all the way. But if I had something that was skewed or maybe had a weird shape to it that I didn't even know what to call it, definitely, if I'm going to talk about unusual observations, absolutely, I'm going to go to Chebyshev's rule because it applies to any shape. And again, we need at least interval data. So, what does the Chebyshev's rule say? Well, first of all, the empirical rule at one standard deviation says that we have approximately 68% of the data. Chebyshev's rule is not applicable because Chebyshev's rule is a calculation that we will do, and the calculation says that you will have at least, this is not approximately, this is at least, which means this much or more, 1 minus 1 over k squared, where k equals the number of standard deviations. That's what k is. So if I'm one standard deviation away, I get 1 minus 1 over 1 squared. That's 1 minus 1, that's 0. So Chebyshev rule technically says you have at least nothing. Well, that's pretty stupid. It's actually about as useless as you can get. That means you could have anywhere from nothing to all the data. Well, duh. That's totally useless. So Chebyshev rule, we don't really even start applying until we hit two standard deviations. So the empirical rule says we would have approximately, at two standard deviations from the mean, approximately 95% of the data. Where Chebyshev says you can have at least 1 minus 1 over, it says two standard deviations, that's 2 squared, that's 1 minus a fourth, that's 3/4, which is 75% of the data. Now, again, remember, this is at least 75%. So these actually agree with each other. Empirical rule says approximately 95. Chebyshev says 75% or more. So these do not disagree with each other. At three standard deviations, the empirical rule we say is approximately 99.7%. And then Chebyshev's we'd say is 1 minus 1 over 3 squared. That's 1 minus 1 ninth, which is obviously 8 ninths, which is, I'm going to round it and say 89%. When you put that in a calculator, you see that's actually like 0.8888888888. So I'm just going to round it and say approximately 89%. So Chebyshev said you'd have at least 89% within three standard deviations, and empirical rule says approximately 99.7. So at least 89 and approximately 99.7, they don't disagree with each other. Chebyshev's would work for something that's mound shape. I'll come back to that in a second. At four standard deviations, we really don't apply the empirical rule because you can see we basically have it all already. The Chebyshev's would say 1 minus 1 over 4 squared, which is 1 minus 1 over 16, which is 17 sixteenths. Oops, I can't believe I actually said 17 sixteenths. 15 sixteenths, there we go. And when you put that into a calculator, you get, I'm going to put it as 93.75. So you could say 94%. That's fine. You'd have at least 94%. Let me sort of write that down here. It's 94%. So you see that again, Chebyshev won't disagree with the empirical rule because if I go out farther with this mound shape, I'm going to have a lot more than 99.7. So 94%, at least 94% does not disagree with this. So you can use Chebyshev's on any shape of data, which also means mound shape, but you wouldn't want to. The reason you wouldn't want to is because the empirical rule would be much more accurate. I mean, what's more accurate to say I have approximately 95% or at least 75%? The approximately 95% is much more accurate. And Chebyshev's is actually kind of an introduction to, let's see, find a spot, I can write it here. The idea of non-parametric procedures. We'll deal a lot with non-parametric procedures later on. The basic idea behind non-parametric procedures is we don't have a, I'll call it now an underlining shape that we're depending on. The empirical rule depends on this underlining shape. The Chebychev's rule doesn't. It doesn't care what shape it is. This is always going to hold true. And there is a large class of non-parametric techniques that we'll be looking at much later that will go hand in hand with all the parametric techniques that we use. So again, let's take a look at our data, and based on our data, which rule would best apply? Well, this data is definitely skewed left. So if I want to pick out an observation, try to decide whether it was unusual or not, and I want to describe the distribution in some way other than simply a graph, then Chebychev's is absolutely the way I would go about doing it. This would so not be a good candidate for the empirical rule.